Welcome, ladies, to the Real Estate Investor Show, providing inspiration, strategies, and insight to empower women investors to live balanced and financially free lives. Now, here are your co-hosts, Liz and Andresa.
InvestHERs, as we all know, financing deals in today's market can be a bit challenging at times. If you're looking at funding your next real estate transaction, we are so excited to introduce to you Fund That Flip.
Fund That Flip is a lending partner dedicated to grow your real estate investment portfolio. They specialize in fix and flip, buy and hold, new construction, and cash out refi for 1 to 4 units.
Ladies, we have known the founder, Matt, and his team for many years now, and we can assure you that their support goes beyond just lending money. They become a true partner.
So if you're looking for great terms and reliable service, check out fundthatflip.com/investher.
Welcome back, ladies. This is Liz.
And this is Andresa.
And welcome back to the Real Estate InvestHER Show, where we are up to inspiring, empowering, and connecting women to live financially free and balanced lives, and whatever balanced means to you. Yes. So today we have a minisode, and this is a 10-minute quick punch of something that we, you know, myself or Andresa speaks of, and we do it in 10 minutes or less, and hopefully give you some nuggets, some takeaways, so you can immediately apply it in your own businesses. So Andresa is on the stage today.
Woo!
And we're going to get right to it because women don't have a lot of time.
No.
So what are we talking about today, Andresa?
You know, one of my favorite topics is Airbnb. And we always get this question on our Facebook community. By the way, we have a Facebook community.
We do?
Yep. Yeah. If you're not part of it, if you're not part of it yet, it's free. So come and join us, or check it out, check it out around your area. Our local meetups, we have 22 as of now. It might be more by the time we release this episode around the country. So check it out. We are expanding pretty quickly.
And yeah.
Have one and you are interested in running one, just send us an email and we can get in contact. All right. So let's get this moving here. I'm going to talk about Airbnb. And one of the biggest questions that I get all the time is that, should I Airbnb or should I not Airbnb? And my answer is always the same. It depends.
So you love that. You love that answer.
Yeah. Right. So here's what I'm going to share with all of you guys today. What are my 3 topics. What do I think every time that I look at a deal? What do I think first? So I'm going to share 3. The number one, ladies, is the law, right? So how to deal with the law? In some markets, there are already laws in place, which is great. So you just follow what is in your market. And when there's no law in place, what should you do? It doesn't really matter to me if there is a law or not. I always, always run the numbers with a plan B. The plan B is if the law changes or if a new law comes up, a new regulation comes up, would I still be able to run this property with positive cash flow long term? If the answer is yes, if I can do that, renting out long term, so that's good. I'll do it. If the answer is no, if I cannot run long term and it will put me in a financial situation with negative cash flow, I'm not going to appreciate that in any shape or form. I'm not going to do Airbnb just because of the highs of Airbnb. At the end of the year, I'm just going to use the image over here for those of you that are on YouTube, right? At the end of the year, you have ups and downs because we have seasons. And is the average that really matters at the end? Not all the ups. So when I run the numbers, I understand that there are rainy days in Airbnb and you need to take that in consideration. So law is my number one tip. I look at that. My number two getting confused. Number two is the market. Is the market, the location, the neighborhood, the block suitable for Airbnb? And what do I mean by that? My neighborhood, you have neighborhoods that are more like closed with gates. I wouldn't do that. They're more residential, right? Or far away. I wouldn't do that. And that's my personal. I am in Philadelphia where you have public transportation a couple of blocks away. Uber is very quick, very easy to get. It's not dependable. Philadelphia is not dependable of a specific season or event. There's tons of shows, concerts, and theater, sports events, marathons going on all year long. So it's not dependable of something specifically. I always look at how walkable things are. Because people want to go to dinner and they want to ride bikes. Sometimes they have dogs, come with kids. So I always like the walkability. So one simple free tip, if you don't know what's going on, open up an account as a traveler on Airbnb and pretend you are coming to the neighborhood and so you can see what's around. What is going on around in terms of what they are offering, what the other competitors are offering, and what are their prices, which ties up with my third and last tip. You got to run your numbers. And I'm dead serious about it. I'm not going to like assumptions, right? So you got to know if you own the property, if you're renting that out, Airbnb, you got to know your PITI, principal, interest, tax, and insurance. You gotta know that. And why you gotta know that? Because I need to understand what is my break even for that property. If I am doing the arbitrage, I'm not familiar, I never done that, so I cannot speak for that. But it's when you rent it from another person. So you take that in consideration. Regardless if you own or if you're renting from somebody, you need to understand your break even. And that's what comes down about understanding your comps, what's going on around, because I want to make sure that in my formula, I look, okay, this property rents for $150 a night. How many nights do I need to rent this house in order for me to at least break even? My number that I feel comfortable with is 12. I need to rent this property 12 days per month in order for me to qualify that property. I don't feel comfortable if I need to rent this property 20 days a month in order for me to at least break even. And you know, people have different criteria and different numbers, but make sure you really understand what will it take for you to get to that point. Don't expect to start off the bat you're just a new listing and already make a lot of money over there. There is a learning curve for your clients, your guests to know you. The goal in the first 6 months is to really build great reviews. And with that, you also want the cash flow, right? But always have a reserve just in case if that doesn't happen during your first 6 months. So that's it. Law your market and run your numbers. If that is no, so the answer is no. If it all looks good, go ahead. So that's it for today.
I love it. And I think, you know, having that criteria takes all the emotion out of it, right? Or if you're in love with a property, you're like, hold on, bing, bing, bing. And if it really doesn't meet the criteria, that's where you're knowing you're getting to the point where you're, you know, investing more smartly, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And it takes less time because you can do that in a day. Basically.
Yeah. Very cool. So we hope you enjoyed this episode. We're always open to ideas for our interview type of show or our minisodes. We just are all about giving the most value we can to you amazing women listening. So thank you for being here with us.
Thank you. Enjoy your day.
If you enjoyed this podcast and want to receive updates on our next interviews, go to our website, therealestateinvesther.com. There, you can subscribe to our show, become part of our investor community, and get updates on upcoming episodes.
If you like our show, please share it with other women who would benefit. And don't forget to leave us a rating on iTunes. We'd really appreciate it. And as always, we encourage you to take one action as a result of today's show and put it into motion so you can live both a financially free and balanced life. Thanks for spending time with us.
Ciao.